Hello everybody, welcome back to Red Tool House. What we're doing today is we are working for the mission. You've watched some of the videos in the past. What we do is there's a local rescue mission that we work with, a good organization we've been proud to be a part of. And these guys in the programs have been raising these chickens. They've been caring for them. They've been out on pasture. We did 300 broilers out on pasture. Raised 300 broilers on pasture. Today's processing day, and got a great crew of volunteers and guys in the program that are working on this. Been really exciting building up to this point. That's what today is. We're processing about, I think with loss, what do we have? 260 is what they're saying?
I think that's what they're
saying. Yeah. So this system we're on right now is pretty cool. We've got our killing station over here. We've got our rotisserie dunker. We've got our picker. We've got our evisceration table and our chill tank. And we've even got a secondary evisceration table set up here for what we need. And the guys are bringing the birds in and dispatching. And the game plan is to do these 260 in one day. We're starting in hour two, and I believe we're coming up on about 80 birds. So we're doing a pretty good run there. We got 224 birds processed and put through the system. We took 124, bagged them up for retail as whole birds in our shrink wrap process. And the way that works, of course, is you shrink bags, put the chicken in, put it in 100 degree water, shrinks it up, put your label on, and you're ready to go into the freezer. We had another 100 that we, after we processed them, we took them down to the commercial kitchen at the mission where the chefs, the guys down there, the cooks, they busted them up, broke them up into individual pieces. So we had 100 birds cut into individual cuts. It's my understanding they even fried up some of the necks down there, and some of the guys were down there eating the necks. So they were giving it their seal of approval there. But I want to talk about this trailer real quick. This trailer comes from a group called Refresh Appalachia. And a little chicken got stuck to my finger still. Oh, come off. Refresh Appalachia. You can check them out at refreshappalachia.com. But they are tied to a nonprofit. They're actually tied to a group called the Coalfield Coalition that's working to get Southern West Virginia coal miners expanding their horizons, getting the training them for other work, other processes. So they have this trailer for rent. And this is great. This is probably a $10,000 to $15,000 setup if I had to guess. But really nice six station killing station here. We had a rotating scalder, propane powered. We had a nice picker. Had a two-person evisceration table, and had a first rinse or first dunk tank. And of course, we were using just a turkey deep fryer to do the heat shrink over here under the carport. 12-foot trailer, again, propane driven, just needs electric, some water hookups. Really impressed with it. And locally, the way this worked out for us, the way their rate is, again, check your ag extension, check with your state to see if you guys have options like this around your area for renting this equipment. Man, you talk about really, really cutting down on the time of processing. You know, 224 birds, and really only had about four people that had ever processed an animal before here. So really cool. Kelly and I had the most chicken processing experience. So really cool to be able to bust through that many birds in one afternoon. I mean, we're looking at 8 to 3 o'clock in about a half hour to 45 minute lunch. That's about 7 hours, about 6.5 hours we were able to do all those birds. So really excited about that. But check around, because there's a lot of companies and nonprofits that are popping up utilizing these services or providing these services. And I love this, that you can rent this for the day or for the weekend. And our total out of pocket for this renting was $160, but that included a $50 cleaning fee, or cleaning deposit. If we clean this up and return it back as clean as we got it, then we get that $50 back. So you're really only looking at $110 out of pocket. So if you look at that, the price per bird, if we did 224 birds and it costs us about $110, then you see we're just under 50 cents a bird. And if you send them out to be processed, you know, you're gonna pay $2 plus for processing. So really good. Obviously our staff was all volunteers, so we didn't have any labor there. But this organization, if you rent from them, they'll even give you the opportunity to hire some of their guys for $6 an hour to come in and help. So in about 4 weeks, you know, we're scheduled to process on Red Tool House our 100 birds. So I'm really strongly considered bringing this in and doing the same thing, because man, this makes light work of it. So be sure to check around. If you're interested in one of these mobile units, check around. Your state may have something tied to an ag extension, tied to a nonprofit that's ag-based. Just kind of do a Google search of that and see what's around, or call your local county extension or your ag office to see if there's an opportunity like that. All right, well, that was a quick overview of what we had going on. That's tied up our weekend. Really excited to work for this organization. They're a great organization. They do a lot of good things in addiction recovery, homelessness, and just poverty in general in our state. So if you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If you haven't subscribed yet, be sure to subscribe. Check us out on our website at redtoolhouse.com, and be sure to sign up for any newsletter. All right, take care, everybody.